An old rivalry returns to Champaign for the first time in 2.5 years. Game one of this weekend series between the Iowa State Cyclones and the Illinois Fighting Illini. Two teams looking to build, one in particular fighting for their playoff lives as the regular season rushes toward its conclusion. Good evening, everyone, from the Big Pond in Champaign, Illinois, and live on the Illini Hockey Network. On the call, I'm George Corey. Where do we begin with this matchup? So many connections, a history of heated contests, thrilling contests, and deciding contests late in the season. It was 2 years ago when Iowa State knocked off a surging Illinois team in St. Louis, ending up as the last hurrah for Nick Fabrini and a lot of the star seniors on the Illini. A lot of the current seniors for this Iowa State team were there and played a role. And now the shoe's on the other foot with this Illinois squad looking to bump them off and return the favor. Both teams with a lot on the line in these next 27 hours, and not just on account of its rivalry status. This Iowa State team, well, they're ranked 22nd right now in a league with a 20-man playoff. Again, they are fighting for their playoff lives. It sure looked that way on the road against 6th-ranked Ohio last week. They almost had the Bobcats on the ropes before giving up 4 goals in the third period, unraveling en route to a heartbreaker of a loss on Friday. Saturday, they couldn't find the back of the net. On the outside looking in, and with no conference tournament to show for anymore, this is a team in must-win mode for the last 3 weeks of the season. And a win certainly wouldn't hurt on the other side either for an Illinois squad which has dropped their last three. They gave up 12 goals last weekend to a McKendree team which they nearly swept in November. They might need to enter the series with a goldfish memory. A lot of chances early on net, early in those games, but they couldn't cash in. And the litmus tests, which have thoroughly defined their season thus far, continued to shine. Just return to your roots, another phrase we've heard to describe this team. Be physical, muddy the game up around the boards, and use what started as a weakness but has slowly developed into a weapon as the season has gone on, that speed in the middle of the ice. Our thanks to public address announcer Nick Miner on those starting lineups. Brought to you by Skender, the general contractors behind the premier construction experience. Visit Skender.com to learn more. A few notable changes for Illinois, and it's driven by a few absences on the left side of the puck. No Gregory Ettingen tonight, no Nick Anderson tonight for Illinois. That bumps Matthew McDonald up to the first line, and Atticus Helfer back to a spot he's known for 3 years, left defense. He had a lot of time on left wing this season. He goes back to where he started with this Illini team with some of the deficiencies that they have up front. He moves back, and on the other side, the notable story, Brett Anderson getting the start over Harrison Moen tonight for the Cyclones. Harrison, a player who in 4 games has given up 21 goals in that span. The normal backup getting the start tonight in place of Moen for Iowa State. Let's drop the puck, shall we? These two teams looking to get the monkey of the lost monkey off of their back, and we are underway. Matt Veeve chasing that one down. Man opposing him, near side half wall, pulled out now by Iowa State. Pass goes through everybody, chased down now. That's John Kaverick and Luke Alpe right there for Illinois. Mazurek will glove that one early. And Mazurek starting in his 7th game in a row for Illinois, with Nolan Woodring being sidelined. The senior netminder has held his end of the bargain for the most part. Again, a rough week all over for everyone last week on this Illinois side against McKendree. But he has played very well, made a lot of stretch saves from one side of the crease to the other. And at times as well, over those 6 games, his defense has given him a lot more run support. Both have been true. And again, the struggle for Illinois is, can you play clean right out of the gate? The Friday games have not been kind to them, and let's see if they can get that monkey off their backs as well. Turnover now in the offensive zone as a shot goes high there off the stick of Sam Dorfman. Iowa State still controls, far side now swung over. Nelson, quick shot in, a lot of deflections, and that does not go. Nelson has it back now at the point, trying to keep it in. Will poke check it around as Matthew McDonald was right there. McDonald and Nelson vying for it on the near side half wall. Alpe trying to pull it out. He collides with Kaverick. Kaverick making a lot of impact plays along with Nelson early here in the first minute for Iowa State. Line change for Illinois. Nelson still has it. In the neutral zone they go. Picked off by Harrison Slovic, fresh off the bench. Too much traffic in the way for him to do anything there, and turned aside. Now going through the legs of one is Kaverick. Fires one point blank range. Swallowed up by Mazurek. John Kaverick and Ryan Nelson making their presence felt thus far for Iowa State. Nelson and Larson, the top line defense, getting the start for the Cyclones tonight. And again for Illinois, a bit of some shuffling around due to some players who will be sidelined tonight. Faceoff still being fought for. The captain, Bogdanoff, nearly had it. Now it goes to the half walls. Bogdanoff sends Jacob Schultz into the boards. Now to the near side equivalent. Harrison Slovic trying to nab that through traffic. He cannot. Turning that one around, forced to an odd angle by Zhuzhebetkov. There is Everett Veselin. Veselin, the best player on this team for the Cyclones. It's in the name, perhaps, but he's also leading the way with 8 goals as he fires one there and swallowed up. Veselin recently sent to that front line, swapped for Kaverick. It was Stu Pearson, the captain, alongside Michael Mulcairn and Kavarik. Veselin recently took the former's place, and it has really impacted him. 2 goals last week, leading the team now with 10 on the season. Still being fought for on the far side, but Iowa State has to reset. Kazmierczak dumps that in. Alpe to chase it down, now in the trapezoid. Illinois trying to clear it. Iowa State's beating them to it. They're not doing a lot of wrong things when they do try and clear it. It's just the passes they make. The Cyclones are being pretty quick thus far. 2:07 having gone by. No shots yet in on Brett Anderson. A face off now. That's Devonport and Bailey McCarthy. Before Devonport, they'll head to the bench. Again, both teams looking to get the lost monkey off of their backs. Iowa dropped two last weekend in thrilling but still heartbreaking fashion to the Ohio Bobcats. Near side, Andrew McLean looking to get it in. He's harassed and drawn off the puck. Aiden Taylor right there for Illinois. A few more men converge on it. That one goes closer to the trapezoid now, but it's controlled by the Cyclones. Ian Devonport, Iowa State's trying to clear it. Illinois is using that signature forecheck. They might have it here. Still being fought for. Taylor comes to help out McCarthy, and it will delay the clear for now. Near side, McLean right there poking it away. Iowa State still able to get it in neutral zone, gaining it now, Sam Eaton. Eaton sent back to the point, collision at the half wall, 2-on-1 in favor of Illinois. Cyclones still come away with it. Sent across the far side now, looking for a shot. And off a few deflections, that one will go wide. Luke Alpe looks to get Illinois set up. He holds onto it now and fires. First test pass for Brett Anderson. Again, no Harrison Bowen tonight in goal. He is watching this one from the Iowa State bench at the moment. It's Brett Anderson getting the start for the Cardinal in goal. McDonald, he gets a lucky carom there. Now makes a few men miss. Odd angle. Save made. Floats into the trapezoid. Ryan Nelson looking to clear. A man on a six. That's the aforementioned McDonald. Now trying to get around two men. He splits the defense, but he's met by McDonald before he sends him into the boards. Nelson making three men miss over the last 10 seconds. 50-50 puck battle pulled out to Iowa State. Nelson has it. Give and go. That's pulled out to the near side point. Shot deflected right there from Alexander Matvey. Far side now. And that one deflected back away. That's going to be the big test tonight, is Iowa State's offensive ability against Illinois shot blocking. Near side now, Joe Dorian, a man on his six, finds Matvey. Matvey with Aslan Zhizhebetkov to his left, looking for an angle. Goes around one man trying to gain the zone. Too many Cyclones in the way there as that poke check gives them a wide open chance. And a point blank save, another one, and a beauty from Ben Mazurek. 4 minutes having gone by here in period number one. And a lot of the strengths of Iowa State correspond to a big strength of Illinois. The Illini shot blocking is going to be tested tonight by the offensive aggression of Iowa State. The speed, they fire from anywhere. They don't need a lot of room to fire. The shot speed, the quickness, and a lot of quick cuts and sharp turns that will go up against another one of Illinois' strengths, that being the individual defense. There was the individual defense of Iowa State winning the day, still being fought for in the neutral zone now, and the Cyclones control. They've controlled a lot of the ice time here, roughly in the first 5 minutes. A few men collide, Illinois looking to clear it, and they do. That one off the stick of David Ettinger. Still being fought for now in the neutral zone on the near side. Pulled out towards the eye, holding onto that one now, Nathan Dash. He can't go around Kavarik. Kavarik forces him to the edge. Very pesky play from Kavarik and Nelson thus far for the Cyclones. They've been the MVP for Iowa State so far in this game. Near side now, Dorfman trying to go around one man. Beautiful block there from Atticus Helford to deny that. It's pulled out now in the slot. Trying to clear it is Luke Alpe, and he does. Great plays there from Alpe and Helford to deny that for Illinois. Mazurek gets active with the stick in the trapezoid. Alpe's right there. A man on his six. Kavarik right there. Who else? Alpe feeds it across to Aiden Taylor. Taylor with a burst of speed trying to go around one man. Still being fought for. Caroms in and swallowed up by Anderson. And in situations in the season where Illinois has not had a lot of time to get active in the set offense in their own O-zone, that is how they have turned to scoring chances, is the odd man rushes and the transition hockey. There, it was the freshman centerman Aiden Taylor displaying just that with some help from Luke Alpe. And maybe that's a way Illinois can get a boost here as Iowa State has controlled most of the time of possession to start. Quicker in the neutral zone right there is Andrew Franey. Sends that back towards the slot. Bailey McCarthy, one of Illinois' best forecheckers, looking to apply one there. That pass goes through a Cyclone, and now Alpe will control far side in his own zone. Andrew McLean has to chase that one down, and this might be an icing. No, it is not. Riley Kress getting his first ice time, sends that across. That's Michael Mulcarron. Now Besslin, again, the player to watch for Iowa State. Two goals last weekend against Ohio. Still being fought for. That one goes through Besslin. Chased down for it between him and Alex Leskai. Besslin sends that one in. Got a deflection, but it went wide. Again, the ability to fire from anywhere, a signature of this Iowa State team. We saw it on display against Ohio last week. We just saw it on display right there as Alex Leskai will look to clear for Illinois. He does, and play stopped. Yes, in that series against sixth-ranked Ohio, the Cyclones hung in both games. They nearly had the upset Friday night. They nearly had that quad one win, if you will, to use a March Madness term that they have been looking for this whole season. Again, ranked 22nd in a 20-team ACHA playoff. So every game is a must win for this Iowa State team. If this game weren't already high stakes enough, as that deflection nearly went. Tyler Schwartz now trying to converge on it. Slovic sends him down. Good poke check there by Bogdanoff. But Slovic's action in on Tyler Schwartz might force a penalty. And it does. Harrison Slovic sent Tyler Schwartz down in the defensive zone on the near side. And this will give Iowa State a power play. Top line on, it's Mitch Krebsbach. Besslin to his right, faceoff won by Illinois. Alexander Matveev, the team's best centerman, responsible for that, and he will kill some time. Nelson to his left, Iowa State looks to rush. They have three bunched on the far side of the ice, make that four. Besslin looking for an angle, turned aside now by Nathan Dash, forced all the way back around for Ryan Nelson. Nelson far side, trying to find the man in the middle there. Great poke check there by Nathan Dash to deny that. They still get a shot off, and they score! That looked to be Ryan Nelson in the right place at the right time. Dash had the poke check, but Iowa State salvaged that. Led by Nelson. Quick power play goal for a team that really needs help on the man advantage this season. They were under 10% on the power play entering this season. And that is a huge step. And it gives them goal number one. Again, off the stick of Ryan Nelson. 7.5 minutes into this one, Iowa State finds themselves ahead. And again, a topic of discussion for Illinois last week as they had a lot of great chances in on the McKendree netminder, but they couldn't convert, and that was in both games. So we haven't really seen the same here through the first 8 minutes of this game. Again, the goal from Ryan Nelson and the first scoring of the evening for either team. Iowa State looking to clear it. Illinois being aggressive in their own O-zone. Fight for it now. Bogdanoff chases that one down as a few Cyclones get hit on the boards. Illinois has been the more physical team thus far. Alpi now, but right on cue, he gets hit. Iowa State controls in their own doghouse. Iowa State making quick work of the ability to swing the puck, although unable to hold onto it there was Sam Dorfman. And icing called as he flung that one back. Iowa State's speed has really showed in the first 8 minutes here, the ability to swing it around, the ability, again, to fire from anywhere that we've talked about. And again, the shot speed, the quickness. We knew coming in it was going to test the reaction time of already a very quick Illinois defense and netminder. And it's 1-0 in that game within the game so far for Iowa State. The quickness of theirs against the quickness and blocking of Illinois. So what can Illinois do to get some offensive pressure? Only three shots thus far, two of them in transition and on Brett Anderson. How can they get set in their own offensive zone? It really starts with the neutral ice where Iowa State has locked down with speed and poke checking ability thus far. They do control it now in their own O zone. Looking to move to his left is Riley Kress. Three man weave there, near side. Looks for a touch pass, couldn't get one. Press back on the near, plays the ricochet game. That one flung into the Illinois zone, going around one man in the trapezoid, Sam Eaton. Eaton looking for a lane, pass in the slot. That was dangerous there. Andrew McLean's gonna wanna have that one back for Illinois. He's fed that one back towards the low slot. And Ben Mazurek may have just bailed him out right there. Again, some new defensive pairings for Illinois in this one with Atticus Helfer moving back on defense. Again, Joe Dorian and Nathan Dash, Alpi and Slovic. Those have been the pairings this year, and we haven't really seen much different to start out. So some new pairings tonight for Illinois, particularly Helfer and Alpi, who both veterans, although they still haven't had a lot of time playing together. That one caroms off McDonald, backhand and a pretty save there from Anderson. But there you go, progress for Illinois as they're able to foment some stable pressure in the offensive zone. Again, you see right there, the top line in, Helfer and Alpi on defense together. And a very interesting decision on that top line as well. McDonald, Matt Vive, and Verassi. The decision to move Matthew McDonald up front. Three streaky players for Illinois. They all play very similarly. Iowa State trying to muddy up the game at the half wall on the near side. And they're able to clear it. Trying to move around one man there is Krebsbach. Can't get it close. Alpi hammers him. That one goes through a few men. A few bodies cancel each other out. Iowa State still able to control for the time being. Besslin goes wide off of a few sticks. Right there to try and send that one back. Now in the trapezoid. Forced all the way around there. Good defense by Helfer. Illinois trying to clear. A few more sticks cancel each other out. Iowa State still with it. Turning around, Stu Pearson, the captain. Helfer with a great job to force him to the outside. Helfer's been the best defensive maven in this game for Illinois. That one goes high. Back to Pearson. Trades places now. Looking for a lane. And full body block right there from Anthony Verassi, denied that shot. 10.5 having gone by here in the first period with really only one or two exceptions. The time has been roughly spent all in the Illinois zone. Illinois really only had one series of set offensive pressure thus far. Two shots in transition, two shots in set, that's been it. Right off the faceoff, they tried to get that one close, deflected from Alpi. John Jarecki now half wall. Fire one in, full body block there from Verassi. Beautiful play there, he clears it. 2-on-2, Verassi with McDonald to his left. Chips it in, tries to go around a man. McDonald chasing that down now. Man gets hit along the boards there. That's McDonald as he's fighting for it alongside Alec Bogdanoff. Bogdanoff trying to feed a pass to the point there. Illinois trying to keep it in, they cannot. Speedy play there, and now he has the puck. Fires one in, wide. Off the back of the netting now, that one caroms around to the near side. Illinois will play the ricochet game and clear. Again, Iowa State swinging it right back. They're wasting no time, trying to reapply some pressure. And Mazurek will freeze time there. Multiple facets, it looks through 11 minutes of this first period that the speed of Iowa State has been the difference. Shot blocking for Illinois has come in a close second as they've picked it up over the last few minutes. Right there in the middle of that was Zhuzhebetkov. He has it now as that one moves closer to the trapezoid. 50-50 puck battle, trying to go around Bogdanoff. He cannot. Zhuzhebetkov sends that around. Now Dorian plays the ricochet game. Right there to handle that is David Ettingen. Illinois looks to clear. Ettingen to Dorian. Now towards the near side. Dorian feeds that. Tried to find Slovic. Too hot for him to handle. Jack Carroll trying to turn that around. Illinois applying the forecheck here. It's David Ettingen, another one of those signature aggressors for Illinois. sent into the neutral zone now, chased down for it between Dorian and Eaton. Dorian has it now, near side corner, Bogdanov, Karams, Slovic. Slovic with two men to his right, forced to the outside now, in the trapezoid, looking for a lane, sent away with the stick, and a beauty there from Anderson. That one Karams out, though, as Helfer had a shot, turned aside. Fighting for it there, McCarthy, some hand shoving there from Ian Devenport. Iowa State clears and ices. 7:40 left to go in this first period. Again, the lone goal coming from Ryan Nelson. A much needed one for the power play's sake for Iowa State. We're seeing this top defensive line play a lot of time for Illinois. Atticus Helfer and Luke Alpe. Again, a new formation because of some injury struggles the Illini have on the left side of the puck, but Helfer in particular has had a lot of time thus far, and he's made the most of it. He has it now as he looks to rush across. In the neutral zone now, forced to his left, still trying, and has to circle back. Pesky play right there from Sam Dorfman. Luke Alpe now sends that one around. Helfer Karams fights forward along with Mitch Krebsbach. Iowa State able to keep it in. Beautiful feed to Krebsbach, shot wide. Kaverick with it now. Iowa State looks to get set. Trying to feed one in. Poke check there. Nelson still able to hold on to it. Sends a backhand wide. And now Alpe. Iowa State controls in the neutral zone. Again, the speed of the Cyclones starting to show roughly in the last 20, 25 seconds. Kaverick near side. The speed and the chemistry. They've answered the call on a lot of quick passes that they have had here in this first period. A lot of close, quick passes as Illinois has been on their six. Matveev, Kaverick harassing him. Kaverick and Nelson have both been all over this game in the first period. McDonald, that one goes through him, chased down for it. Iowa State will control. David Ettington tries to cut that one off. Trying to go around one man, has some help. Too many bodies in the way, though, there as the Illinois defense wins that one out. Zhizhebetkov fires, poke checked away from Ferrassi. That one goes to Iowa State. A few more bodies collide. Illinois starting to crowd the puck en masse now, and it's starting to work as Iowa State looks to foment something in the O-zone. Alpe trying to poke check it away and does. Illinois starting to crowd the puck. They're starting to shade it heavily to one side. Matveev lays a boom. And now McDonald on the other side. One against four, has a lane, sends it wide. Bogdanov now, David Ettingen right there. Bogdanov looking for a lane, circles back around. Tried to send one across both seams, controlled now by Jack Carroll. He clears it before he collides with Slovic. Two more men converge on that. Line change for Illinois as it's in their own O zone. One on two there, trying to hold on to that is David Ettingen. Slovic helps him out. Slovic moving towards the net, right in front. Ettingen couldn't handle the pass. Backhand nearly goes, wide open lane there. And that was very close from David Ettingen. Illinois starting to pick up the speed and again starting to crowd the puck. They're starting to find an answer for this neutral zone attack of Iowa State. 5 minutes left here in the first period. Slovic fires wide. And again, transition hockey and picking up the speed is historically how Illinois has been able to produce when they haven't had time to get set. That one too hot for Slovic to handle. Line change for Illinois. McCarthy now, the man on the forecheck. As that one goes to the near side. Andrew McLean right there, in on Stu Pearson. Able to get it out right there and move in is Mulcairn. Sent wide, intended there for Beslin. Beslin hammers Alex Leskai and he's still down. A little slow to get up there, but back on. Helfer waits patiently. Looking for an angle, looking for some of his line mates to join him. Tried to find Andrew McLean, could not, near side. Chipped in there, and now a line change for Iowa State. Helfer chases it down again. Atticus Helfer getting a lot of playing time, a lot of ice time here in this first period. 16 minutes having gone by in it, and the first whistle in quite a while. Defensive switching for Illinois continues. It's now Atticus Helfer and Nathan Dash on a line together. That one, Karam's close, right there to take that Helfer. Dash finishes the clear. Verassi trying to get close, active with the stick there is Anderson. Second time we've seen that from him today. Going around Verassi, trying to get a clear in. Near side now, he does, that's Riley Kress. Able to hold on to that one, but not for long. Joe Dorian trying to clear, he's harassed from behind. James Millams right there. Now Alexander Matvey makes a man miss, makes another man miss, clears near side, McDonald. Has a few men to his right, tries to find one of them, that's Joe Dorian. Dorian trades places with him in the near side corner before it's taken now and cleared. Fed on into nobody, looking for the chase. Zhuzhebetkov and Dorian in the crease. 3 minutes, 10 seconds left in the first period. Taken away now by the lone goal scorer, Nelson fires one in. Great save right there by Mazurek. Mazurek with such quickness to lower the left pad to stop that one. Beautiful chance there from Iowa State that he held off. Looking for the touch pass there off the rebound. He couldn't get stick to puck. That was Davenport. Again, Iowa State looking to work quicker here. The speed has been the story for the first period, although there are times where Illinois has found multiple answers to it. Pearson fires, deflected. That one manages to get close. McDonald now. And a hand pass will stop things there. Not only is Iowa State applying a lot of speed and again, multiple forms, the shot speed, the ability to fire from anywhere, a lot of quick cuts and sharp turns to get past one-on-one defenses, but you've seen a lot of examples in this first period from the Cyclones of players getting in the right spots very quickly, particularly on that goal from Nelson. And then just now, the shot from Nelson, there was a man right there looking for a rebound pass. So they're quick in multiple forms. And that has been the driving factor, the top driving factor, that is, of this first period. Poke check there, a few sticks cancel each other out. Near side, right at the red line. Now Luke Alpe chases that one down. Mitch Krebs back on a six. Dash, looks to clear. Closing the gap there and giving Iowa State the possession. That one high off the stick of Dorfman. Nelson near side. Dash across, 3-on-3 here for Illinois. Has it now, looks to feed it to his right. Instead sends it in, deflected off the shoulder. David Ettingen right there, 3-on-2, 50-50 puck battle. Bogdanov has it now. Slovic right there for Illinois. Slovic in the trapezoid, tried to find a man. That one comes out to the point. Dash looking for an angle. They tried to go through the Iowa State defense. Good poke check right there, stick deflection there. Trying to take that one out is Alpe. 1:30 left on the clock here in this first period. Moving in now, trying to find a man. Great placement right there to deny that. Use of the stick there from Nathan Dash. Iowa State had a 2-on-1, Dash denied them. Looking for another chance here, they nearly had one, but David Ettingen denies that. 1:18 left in the first period, off a line change, having a lane, Dorfman. He fires too high and into the netting. 73 seconds left in a first period of 19 shots. One going past the blue paint combined. Face off to the left of Mazurek. Won by Iowa State. Looking to move to his left quickly and does. Sends one in, save made, turned aside. In the right place there again, Mulcairn. That one goes in again, still alive, and swallowed up. And Joe Dorian didn't like the activity from Stu Pearson in on Ben Mazurek, and those two, both longtime veterans, exchanged some friendly words. Again, this is a longtime rivalry that the first time it has been back in this building since October of 2021, and two, that is the last time Illinois has pulled through over this Cyclone team is during that home series on Halloween weekend 3 years ago. We'll have more on that in 55 seconds when the period does come to a close. 50-50 puck battle pulled out by Iowa State. Now Pearson has Alexander Matvey and Anthony Verassi to contend with. Tries to find the man in the middle there. Great poke check there by Helfer and Verassi. That gives McDonald the puck, but he's harassed from behind. 35 seconds left. Iowa State looks to clear. That one sent across toward the bench. Zhuzhebetkov, ricochet game, Verassi in. Late hit on Verassi into the Iowa State bench. Schultz. Far side now, Iowa State. A little bit slower to clear, but they can take a sigh of relief there. 15 seconds left now in the period. In the trapezoid, McDonald right on a man. That one goes through multiples. Jack Kazmierczak right there. Unable to handle that one for the time being. Trying to get his mitt on it is Pearson as he collided with Alpi and does. Right in front. That one went through two men and that will finish period number one. That didn't epitomize the period for Iowa State. I don't know what will. A lot of quick chances. A lot of odd man rushes and two on ones, three on twos where you blink away for a second. And not only do they have something set up in the offensive zone, they've taken away half of the offensive zone with how close they already are to the net. The speed of Iowa State proving to be the top difference maker in the first, although Illinois did have multiple answers for it that they can use and carry over into the second period. One of them the shot blocking, one of them an intense surrounding of the puck handler, particularly in the neutral zone to stop that Iowa State attack. And there were a few chances that they did have in the set offense in on Brett Anderson. But for now, the lone goal coming from the starting defenseman, Ryan Nelson. It is the difference in this first period. We'll be back shortly for the second with more information on this rivalry series and some keys that both teams must employ if they want to win the next 20 minutes. We'll be back for the second after this. Getting ready for the second period of action now. Really only two or three periods of set offense, periods of time that is, that Illinois was able to control in their own O zone. The rest of this came mostly on transition hockey and some odd man rushes, and certainly a majority, maybe a super majority, of that first period was spent on the Iowa State side of the ice. Again, positive developments for Illinois in solving the speed of the Cyclones. A, the shot blocking, that was going to be the big test tonight, the speed against the shot blocking and individual defense. And the second being just the crowding of the puck, another one of Illinois' strengths that for a period of time did hamper Iowa State in the neutral zone. So certainly Iowa State will look to make good on continuing their quickness in the neutral zone. Meanwhile, Illinois get more set pressure in the offensive zone. Only seven shots applied in on Brett Anderson in the first 20 minutes. And as John Opilka's squad talks things over again, they have lost their past three, looking to get the monkey off their back. And again, this is a team who had previously struggled heavily on Fridays, but, you know, after a day of adjustments and being able to pick things up again, they played much better on Saturdays. 2 weeks ago against Purdue Northwest, the script was flipped, and Friday was a very clean game, a very fast and physical game. Saturday, not the case. Last week, they struggled on both days, and so this game, certainly a battle within the battle, Illinois may be trying to prove that the game 2 weeks ago was not a fluke, and in the quest to be more consistent, both games of each of these weekend series. Fight for it in the neutral zone. Matt Veeve able to send it around three men, gains the zone, but forced to his left. A man on his six, that's Ryan Nelson. Nelson, the lone goal scorer in the game, and one of his line mates makes Matt Veeve give it up. Iowa State looking to clear now. Near side, that's John Kavarik. Fight for it in the neutral zone. Check that at the half wall. And eventually it will get indeed into the neutral zone. Now Illinois in their own doghouse, Alvey. Helfer nearly lost that one now, and that might give Iowa State the possession. Kavarik hammers Alvey in, but Alvey able to send that one across. David Ettingen looking to control. Harrison Slovak has it, tries to feed it in there. Bogdanov couldn't get stick the puck. Unable to handle that pass here. Sloppy play from Iowa State is giving Illinois some chances early. They're able to keep it in. Dorian feeds that one wide. Kavarik looks to clear. Slovak says no in the right place at the right time. That one gets close and swallowed up by Anderson. A third area where Illinois perhaps had the upper hand in that first period was on the forecheck. Again, the crowding of the puck, the shot blocking and the forecheck, all three strengths of this Illini squad. And right there, took advantage of some Iowa State misplays and nearly had some good chances. They'll look to do it again with the top line in. Bogdanov wins the faceoff, gets help from Harrison Slovak. 50-50 puck battle there between Slovak and Ben Fannenstein. And the trapezoid now as Ettingen tries to shove that one in and having to come out of the crease on all fours and stop that. Anderson. Again, we've said it 1,000 times, really the best forecheckers on this team for Illinois, the Ettingen brothers, McDonald, Verassi, and Matt Veeve. Three of those four men started the game tonight and have formed this almost makeshift top line for Illinois. And right there, the fourth, David Ettingen, getting very active, causing a lot of mayhem in the trapezoid. Riley Kress now. Aiden Taylor trying to take that away from him. Illinois again, back to that forecheck, applying pressure in the offensive zone. They do get the puck back now. Andrew McLean looking to turn around. Fires! Taylor trying to cause mayhem in front. Still alive and deflected. Into the trapezoid now. Who can be the first one to grab it? It's Fannenstein. Near side. Zhizhebetkov tries to keep it in. A man beats him to it. That's Beslin. With a burst of speed, Beslin. Taylor trying to force him left. Corner now. Pulled out. Shot at the point. Deflected left. Now Andrew McLean controls and clears. Back to neutral ice now. A few more men converge on it. A man goes down. Illinois applying more physicality here. Now Bailey McCarthy in his own doghouse with a man to his left. will slow things down for Illinois. 2.5 having gone by here. And Illinois certainly with a lot of chances in front of the net in that time. That one rolls around towards the trapezoid. Fannenstein and Matveev there. McDonald trying to shove Fannenstein. Matveev right there though, fires one. Save made by Anderson. Anderson, extension of the glove hand there, denied that one from the air. That one manages to get close. Skirmish in front, save made again. And Illinois not happy as Anderson just knocked his helmet off. And the linesmen converging, discussing things over, one of them having a word with Anderson. But you're starting to see Illinois return to another thing that slowly over the season has become one of their defining factors, that being the doorstep goals, collecting rebounds in front of the net, creating scrums and skirmishes down low. Most games this season, it has been Joe Dorian and Sasha Matveev who have set up shop right in front of the net, whether for screens, whether to try and get rebounds again, whatever you can do to get the netminder out of his comfort zone, to get him over to one side. You send four or five bodies over there to try and disrupt his vision, disrupt his idea of where the puck is, and it has led to a lot of Illinois goals, particularly over these last six games. And so a good adjustment there made by John Opilka in between periods one and two of sending more men towards the low slot and the crease. Right there was a little bit of Aiden Taylor. Anthony Verassi sensed blood there as well and came up from his spot at the point. And Illinois with a lot of good licks in on Brett Anderson. They certainly have the energy right now and it feels like they might be on the doorstep. We'll have take two of that faceoff to Anderson's right. Top line on, Matveev, Ferrassi, and McDonald, along with the defensemen, Helfer and Alpi. Matveev wins that one, McDonald sends it to Helfer. Illinois with a lot of rotation here. Matveev has it now, right back towards the circle. Trying to feed it in for McDonald and swallowed up again. That looks like a set play from the beginning with all of the rotations that Illinois had. It gave Sasha Matveev a lane to the right of the net. McDonald got in his spot and Illinois set something up. Line change here for Iowa State. And now it will be Matveev. And that looks to be James Millens. Matveev wins that one again with authority. Helfer thought about firing in, plays the ricochet game. Verassi, far side corner. Back to the point. Helfer fires one, looking for a deflection. That was so close. McDonald, a man on his six, 50-50 puck battle. Matveev right there again. He's saved multiple possessions for Illinois over the last minute and change. McDonald trying to turn that one around, has it taken away. A one-on-one puck battle becomes a two-on-two puck battle. Same thing happens around the corner. Ryan Nelson gets hit, but he was able to win that, and Iowa State controls. Alpi takes it away off the lead pass there. And now Iowa State will reset. Let's see if Illinois can slow them down in neutral ice. Matveev forces a man to the outside, sends another one into the boards. He has made himself active throughout these last 2 minutes, the Russian has. That one sent wide, chased down for it. That will send Ryan Nelson back to his own defensive zone. Line change for both teams. Great shift for that top line there from Illinois. That was huge. Matveev still stays in the game as a reward for his work. That one manages to get close into the slot off a deflection on the trapezoid, but turned aside there by Illinois. That one goes off the skate of Ettingen, but right to a red sweater. Zhuzhebetkov now at the half wall on the near side in the Illinois zone. He's able to clear it. Bogdanov trying to chase it. Turned aside. In the neutral zone, Illinois is slowing Iowa State down with a lot of speed here. A lot of great uses of the stick and some poke checks. Right there, another one from Aslan Zhuzhebetkov to deny that and send it back into the Iowa State zone. Anderson active with the stick. Slovak nearly took that one away, but that gets past everybody. Illinois has to reset. 5 minutes having gone by here. A lot of good looks in on Brett Anderson. Illinois looks to be knocking on the door. Can they get set in their own zone again? We'll find out after this neutral zone faceoff. Pearson and Bogdanov, captain against captain, and the latter wins. Heavy forecheck right there, trying to force some pressure from Everett Beslin. A collision there in neutral ice that will send that back to the Illinois trapezoid. Zhuzhevetkov with Pearson on his six, gives him a snow shower before he's able to clear it. Bogdanov pokes it, that one goes off Beslin, and into the corner. Slovic throws Jacob Schultz into the boards. Able to navigate that one out of traffic right there before going down is Andrew Franey. Slow to get up there. Iowa State still shorthanded, fires one in. Alive in front. Mazurek doesn't know where it is, but it's taken away. Still right in front of fire. And a save. Critical adjustment right there. Ben Mazurek was down on his back and shaded heavily to the near side. And that time it was Illinois almost forcing a scrum on defense, although Iowa State was technically undermanned with Franey down on the other side. It was still almost a 4-on-3. The Cyclones had the advantage of open ice, and Illinois shut off those lanes and gave Mazurek time to get back on his skates. That one goes high. He manages to turn it aside. Iowa State still looking to apply some pressure, and nonchalantly, Ben handles that with the glove. Again, roughly over this stretch of the last few weeks where it has been just Ben Mazurek with Nolan Woodring sidelined for Illinois, both have been true. The defense has given him some more run support, helping him out to avoid some rebounds. And two, he has played incredibly well. A keen ability to keep his eye on the puck in heavy traffic, even with four or five guys in front. That's always been true, but really where we've seen him expand his game over that time are the side-to-side saves, the split saves, the ones where he's shaded heavily, and then he has to react quickly from one end of the net to the other. We have seen a lot of those, and games could have gotten very ugly if he didn't put his foot down there and make incredible saves. Atticus Helfer now trying to help his compatriot out. Although that becomes a 50-50 puck battle, pulled out quickly. Helfer sends that far side. Too hot to handle there for Bailey McCarthy, although it did touch his stick, so icing waved off. McCarthy sends a man into the boards for retribution. Trying to go around one man, he does. Near side, Samuel Eaton. And Illinois will clear again. They do have numbers. Verassi fires one wide. Running to get that one, Matthew McDonald had a lane, taken away quickly. Beautiful block there by Riley Kress. And play stopped there. 7 minutes having gone by in the second period. Illinois has had the slight upper hand in that time, but yet to have a goal to show for it. Iowa State still up 1-0 off of the first period goal from Ryan Nelson. And two, a lot of time for the top two lines on the ice in this game for Illinois. It's the top line out again. It feels like they're almost getting every other shift of the forwards, it seems, between the top and the second lines. Chase down for that one, and it will be iced. Again, it really has been the top two lines for Illinois. You can throw Bailey McCarthy in there. You can throw Zhuzhevetkov on defense, who has had an impact. And Aiden Taylor as well has made some plays in this game. Not a lot from the bottom two other than that. Top line on right now once again, although unable to keep that one in off the deflection is Dorian. And he will turn things around. Active with the stick and the trapezoid, feeds that one around. A man on his six there. That was Nelson, able to get it out of harm's way for the time being, but Illinois delaying this clear. That one sent across both seams now to the far side. Trying for a lane, cut off quite nicely there by Zhuzhevetkov. Iowa State still controls at the far side corner, back to the far side point. Looking to move it in, that one goes wide. Kirby Larson trying to send that one in, odd angle. Now a chase down for it. James Millens has it. Swung around back to the far side. And he may have to reset as he was unable to handle that one. Now he has a man on his six there. Ryan Nelson feeds that one back. And because of Nelson's inability to handle it, Illinois nearly cleared it. Now Iowa State controls, however, both teams getting a little bit sloppy over the last 30 seconds with puck handling. Iowa State still holds on as a shot, save made. Looking for a backhand, taken away by Matveev. Beautiful as he got low to deny that sidewinder. Still unable to clear it, and now they are. Iowa State wasting no time. This is starting to look more like first period Iowa State as Matveev, an open ice hit on Sam Dorfman. Winding up, firing, and beautiful help right there from Bailey McCarthy to deny that rebound. Larson, near side, shoves it in, too hot to handle there for Krebsbach. Illinois with the puck, 2-on-3. Shuzhebetkov can't go around one man, he's forced to his left. Hand shoving there from Ryan Nelson. As those two going after it, Zhuzhebetkov still able to hold on to it, but Luke Alpe can't keep it in. That will briefly give Iowa State the possession. Can Illinois salvage it with the forecheck? Ettingen, Bogdanoff, and Slovic right there. Illinois crowding the puck no matter what part of the ice is involved. Off the pad. Rush off a line change, he fans on that one. Still trying to get in close, too much traffic in the way. Illinois crowded the slot right there. Great defense there. Bogdanoff with three men to his left, fires one. Rebound chance, unable to get anything there. A third chance wide, still there. Bogdanoff, a few sticks cancel each other out. And a beautiful play there from Kaverick to navigate that past Alpe. A lot of scary moments for both teams that have happened very quickly in this game. As we've hit the halfway point of the second period, line change for Illinois. And it is the third line, headlined by McCarthy and Taylor. At the point in their own zone, before it's pulled out, Iowa State resets. Sent to the far side, shoving that in, Mulcairin. McCarthy, Pearson on his six. 50-50 puck battle, and a few men converge on it. They give it right back to the Cyclones. Fanning on that pass there. That one manages to get close. A few sticks cancel each other out. A very muddy game right in front of the net that is denying a lot of shots. Zhuzhebetkov fires, save made, and controlled. Trying to get that through a man there was Besselin, he could not. Karam will go Iowa State's way, is taking that one. Is Mulcairin in the corner, now in the trapezoid. Looking for a lane, looking for a centering pass, sends it wide. They're still playing towards the periphery, Illinois is forcing them to the outside. They deny the centering pass again. Near side corner, right there and playing quite nicely is Jason Lamb. 50-50 puck battle there, that one goes in. And a full extension of the glove from Mazurek denies that. We have seen him get very active with his lower body over the last month and change in this 6-7 game streak that he has anchored things in the Illinois net. Again, we knew coming in that the speed of the Illinois defense and their netminder would be tested tonight with just the overall offensive quickness and aggression that Iowa State displays. And on multiple occasions, Mazurek has held up his end of the bargain. Iowa State will reset. Franey will delay. And now Jacob Schulte. Schulte gets hammered into the boards. Illinois trying to take it away. They do. Matveev helps. Shot goes wide. Atticus Helfer has to run that one down now, and he will. Illinois will reset, although Helfer will have two men coming towards him. Makes one miss, looking for a lane. Now Slovic clears in the middle of the ice. Slovic moves to his left, line change for Illinois. He'll try to kill some time to wait for his line mates to join him. He still has it, tries to find Matveev there in the far side corner. Matveev fighting for it with Devonport. Able to be pulled out by Slovic. Slovic and Matveev playing a little two-man ball here. That one caroms around towards David Ettingen. Had a lane. Matveev fires again wide. Near side now, Zhizhebetkov looking to swing it or reset it. Sent to the half wall. Ettingen unable to handle that. Matveev, first man to it, but Zhizhebetkov able to keep it in. Slovic right there. Back to Matveev. A man harassing him. Matveev trying to pull it out. Fires one again wide. And delayed penalty coming here as Iowa State gets a stick on it. First power play of the evening for Illinois. Slovic and Matveev combining on multiple occasions there. Zhizhebetkov saving a possession for Illinois. And another good example of getting set offensive pressure. Now you have a power play and a chance to turn that into a score. Heading into the box, unhappy with the call, and chirping along the way is Ian Devenport. So now curious to see what happens. Both teams have had the upper advantage when they've been the faster team in this game. That has been true for both, but will Illinois try to slow it down? It's the power play. You have to imagine they will do so. So what can Iowa State do to try and get them out of their comfort zone? Will it be moving to the puck quickly? Will it be crowding them? Will it be poke checks forcing Illinois to the outside? What can Illinois do to maintain control of the possession? And likewise, what can Iowa State do to muddy it up? Right there, perfect example from the ladder. That's Joe Pacana denying that and killing time. Again, in the box for Iowa State is Ian Devenport. Second forward line starting things for Illinois, led by the captain, Alec Bogdanov. Slovic gets it as he feeds that one around, holding onto it. He's still out of his net there, but unable to make anything happen there as a great play to kill time from Kirby Larson. Larson collided there with Anderson, and if an Illinois player got on it, that may very well have been a goal, but Larson holding on right there and also killing time in the process. Bogdanov, and now Illinois will reset. Top line back on. Alexander Matveev finds Verassi. Verassi goes around a man, still forced to the outside now. Can he get it back to the point as Illinois looks to reset? Slovic at the half wall fires. That one elevated. Fanning on that clear will give Illinois the possession again. Matveev far side looking to go in, fires one. Full body block right there and a beauty. Atticus Helfer with the poke check gets the beneficiary of that. Helfer moving in, another fire, looked for the deflection, couldn't get it. Slovic near side, a man looks to send him into the board. Slovic pokes that around to the half wall, that's Bogdanov. 45 seconds left on the minor penalty, 50-50 puck battle, Iowa State mudding this one up. But Matveev has a lane and fires high, save made by Anderson. Particularly in this second period, once again, Illinois has tried to create a lot of trouble right in front of the net. The signature scrum skirmish right in front that gives them a lane and really makes goalies off balanced. And they put a lot of bodies right in front of Anderson, and he has been perfect thus far. David Ettingen vying for the faceoff there, he wins it. Dash fires, and having to get high to stop that one there, again, Anderson. And again, this is a player in Brett Anderson, the backup netminder, who entering into this one, it only played four games and had given up 21 goals in that time. Statistically, at least, he's looking like a much different netminder tonight. Dash ricochets, playing catch now with Alpi. Illinois looking to swing it, but they have been denied until now. Zhizhebetkov moves to his right. Sent across now, Dash, odd angle, has to circle around. 10 seconds left on the power play. Last gasp here for Illinois. Zhizhebetkov near side. They're looking for a lane. Fires one from Alpi. Backhand chance goes wide from Ettingen. 5-on-5 now. Illinois looking to reset in the process. And Iowa State will get some help there as that one bounces into the net. It's felt like Illinois has been knocking on the door for roughly the last 12 minutes of hockey. But credit to Iowa State on that penalty kill for, particularly in that last half minute, forcing a lot of the Illinois players to the edge of the zone, whether it was along the boards or whether it was along that blue line. They did something that Illinois does a lot and got in your face. That one manages to get close to the slot, having to navigate that through traffic is Devenport. He clears it with a burst of speed now on the far side. Pass intended for Kaverick. That turns into a 50-50 battle. Zhuzhebetkov and McCarthy right there for Illinois. They look to clear. Kaverick wins that one-on-two battle with a lane and a shot and a save. 4 minutes, 44 seconds left in this second frame. Again, the prevalence of the top two lines for Illinois has been particularly on display tonight. The top forward line comes back in, and yet another defensive pairing, this time Dorian and Zhuzhebetkov. Devonport and Matveev on the draw. Trying to navigate that one through traffic there was Kaverick. He could not. That comes out to the near side corner. Kaverick now looked for a pass. That one went through everyone. DJ Girardi now to the near side to his line mate Schultz. Matveev looking to clear. He's harassed on either side. Does manage to get it in, and let's see if Matthew McDonald can make anything of it. He cannot. Holding onto that one, Kaverick now. Zhuzhebetkov takes it away off an errant pass. Zhuzhebetkov to Matveev. They looked for a lane there, going down, unable to handle that one. McDonald. Iowa State might have gotten away with one there. That was almost a high check on McDonald. Schultz fed on around. Nice feed to Kaverick. Fires one. Hits his own man before it can get close. Now in the trapezoid. McDonald and able to clear. Still alive and turned aside. Kicked back in, but eventually cleared. Beautiful feed up to Kaverick. Has a lane. Trying to go in. Still alive in the trapezoid. And right and cleared. Now to the half wall on the near side. Corner battle for it. Sent across both seams. Chased down for it between Slovic and Nelson. Kept alive in the meantime. Now on the other corner. 50-50 puck battle once again. There have been a lot of those in this game. Sharp turn there to try and go around. Backhand, too much traffic in the way. Pearson right there for Iowa State, opposing him, Helfer. Pearson at the point, now another Illini man opposing him. Pearson still with it, a lot of traffic in front. Turned aside, up tall. Pearson now in that same location. Looking to go in, looking to send one. That one caroms back to the starting point. Right there, Kirby Larson. Off a deflection, high, and save. Now off a deflection again. Still kept in. Helfer trying to get his mitt on it now. Plays the ricochet game, trying to clear. Larson able to keep it in, but not for long. Tried to get it up there for Verossi, could not. And that will force an Illinois line change. 2 minutes, 15 seconds left in this second period. Right there is Ryan Nelson in a long shift for this Iowa defense as well. Sent back around, that's Larson. Across to Pearson now. Stuart Pearson makes a few men miss before he will reset on the far side. McLean harassing him. Sent on across. That one, very dangerous, very quick. And play stopped. That appeared to go off Stu Pearson's helmet before it caromed towards the back of the net. Looking to clear it quickly, and they do. That one goes through Andrew McLean, however, and it gives Iowa State brief possession. McCarthy able to take it away in neutral ice, now gains the zone before he has it poke checked away from him. Dorian gains it, feeds it in, says a prayer. Coming out of the crease is Anderson. Gives the Cyclones some help. Now on the near side, Joe Pacana. Pacana gets it to a man. Backhand pass. Beautiful save right there. 80 seconds left in this second period. Iowa State has managed to hold off an increasingly aggressive Illinois attack. on the near side, won by Bogdanoff against Krebsbach. A few more men converge on it, able to be kept in by Matthew McDonald. Sidewinder there, swallowed up. And again, the prevalence of this top line, the top two lines for Illinois. You start to wonder, is that going to show itself in the third period? Is the lethargy going to become a little bit of a factor, as those two lines have probably had roughly 80-85% of the ice time 39 minutes in? Bogdanoff will go at it again and pulled away by Kaverick. Forced to his left, looking for a better angle, taken away off that pass by Matveev. Bogdanoff right there, that one goes through two men. Chased down for it now between Franey and McDonald. Back to the near side, that's Schultz. Illinois trying to take it away, it again goes through a few bodies cancel each other out. Helfer right there along with James Millens. 35 seconds left in this scoreless second period. In the corner, pulled out to Iowa State. Millens has feeds it to Schultz. And taken away now on the other side by Verassi. And he will go for a line change. 20 seconds left. McDonald there on the forecheck, but a one-on-three. Nothing much he can do there. Smart play by Alpi to feed it in with 10 seconds left, looking for a last-ditch spot from Illinois, but Iowa State will control. Sent back around by Schultz, chased down for it between Kaverick and Shuzhebetkov, and that will round out period number two. So Illinois certainly pushing and keeping the pressure on Iowa State, but plenty of great saves by Anderson. And you certainly feel this is one of those third periods, this will be, where both teams are knocking on the door. A lot of great steps from both, and they certainly had their moments. So that will round it out for period number two. We will be back for the third frame, 20 minutes left, and still a 1-0 score in favor of the visitors. Back for the final frame in a period that could really swing either direction. The second period saw incremental improvements on behalf of Illinois, getting bodies in front of the net, taking away some of that speed from Iowa State. But it is truly that close where the Cyclones got a lot of good looks on the other side, and one goal either way could very well define the rest of this game. Again, the lone goal in the first coming from the defenseman Ryan Nelson. Since then, there have been plenty of great saves by Ben Mazurek and Brett Anderson. Again, Anderson, a player who everyone was surprised to see him start tonight, giving up over 5 goals a game in the few that he has played this season, almost looking like a different netminder tonight, giving Harrison Moen some time to rest as Moen looks on from the Cyclone bench. The strengths of Illinois, certainly a factor in that second period, almost all of them. Puck blocking, the doorstep efforts, and creating those scrums down low and in the crease, crowding the slot on defense, the forecheck in particular. And two, another factor that may very well turn over into this third period is the frequency of the top two lines. So do we see some lethargy in this third period for players in Illinois? Those two lines have probably had a good 80-85% of the ice time thus far. And again, feeling like a must win in that regard for Illinois. It certainly is a must win for this Iowa State team. We talked about it in the onset. Ranked 22nd in the ACHA playoff bracket, has 20 spots. So it goes without saying they're fighting for their playoff lives right now, and they're still looking for that top tier win. We used the term earlier in the broadcast to sort of compare it to March Madness, that quad one win. You look at their record, they're 8-9, and you ask yourself, how could they be sub 500 and rank even anywhere near the top 25? And the answer, a top heavy schedule, and they have mostly dominated in other games. 6 of those 9 losses for Iowa State on the road to top 10 teams. Central Oklahoma, Maryville, and 2 last week to Ohio. Again, they nearly got that quad one win against the Bobcats Friday night in ultimately what became a heartbreaker. They're hoping that a week later that does not turn into the same scenario. You have to imagine that that's on the minds a little bit. It's in the periphery. It's in the background of a lot of the Cyclone players, is we really want to deny Illinois particularly late in the game, because those last 10 minutes of that third period, that Friday night against the Bobcats, are where they ended up getting all 4 of their goals against Iowa State. And so certainly control the pace and control the game in the first 10 minutes, but we should expect to see that added urgency given that background for the visitors tonight. And again, for Illinois, in terms of the Friday-Saturday battle that they have had to contend with really for the past 10, 11 games, it's been a little bit in between tonight. We've seen some great plays, some great handling of the puck. The speed has been there, the physicality has been there, and the shot blocking and regular defense have been there. Really, the only area where it has corresponded to a Friday game has been the inability to handle some pucks, and they've let some good passes get away from them. Iowa State controlling things to start now in their offensive zone as a few men collide into the boards. Verassi sends that around one man before he clears. McDonald trying to chase after it. John Kavarik, the first man to meet him. Those two fighting for it in the far side corner in the Iowa State zone. That becomes a 2-on-2 battle. Joe Dorian trying to keep it alive for Illinois. He cannot. As taking that one now and moving quickly is Ryan Nelson. Nelson plays the ricochet game and avoids one man. Tries to send it across there. Great poke check there from Matt V. Cyclones keep it in as a man sends Zhizhbetkov into the boards. Right there to help him out, though, is Alexander Matveev, and now McDonald clears near side. McDonald again forced to the outside. We'll play that one all the way around off the stick of Anderson. Caroms a few more before Kavarik. will attempt the delayed clear. And now that occurs. Again, that one going through a few men. Iowa State has had the benefit of a lot of caroms and a lot of bodies and sticks canceling each other out tonight. Looking for a touch pass there. Kavarik's mad he didn't get that one. Still trying to go in. Now off the backhand. Another chance in front. Another backhand as Mazurek down on all fours, and he's able to hold on to that one. Visible frustration from Michael Mulcairn there as he had two backhand chances in front with Mazurek down. And the Illinois veteran goaltender has had to make multiple forms of that very save tonight. A lot of those types of saves, both ugly and where he's had to stretch from one end of the crease to the other, that if he doesn't make those saves, these games and this stretch of 7-8 games could get very ugly for Illinois. The forecheck, a continual presence here for the Illini in this game. Able to clear it though on the other side, sending it through the legs of one. Pearson trying for a lane, pass too hot to handle. Andrew McLean gets the benefit of that ricochet now. Bestlund looks to clear and does. Alpi takes it away from him. And it's ultimately controlled by the Cyclones. Near side, Pearson moving in, trying for a lane. That one goes through everybody and swallowed up. Iowa State certainly playing faster through these first 2 minutes and 12 seconds of the period. And they seem to be developing a little bit of mojo going from one end of the ice to the other. So as Illinois talks things over right in front of their net, what adjustments will they make? Again, the strength of this team, we saw it a little bit in the second period, has been crowding the slot in the middle of the ice on defense. That might have to be the first adjustment they make going into this third period. Zhuzhebetkov handles the faceoff, still has it, far side, over to Verassi. Verassi with a man on his left trying to go around two Cyclones. And Iowa State will finish the job. They will win that battle. Near side, trying to clear it now. A man on his six, that's Riley Kress. Kress gives it away. Matt Veeve, right in front, still alive. Second chance doesn't go for McDonald. Illinois still controls. Dorian near side, sends it back around to Verassi at the corner. Verassi gets hammered now, and that will give it temporarily to Kress. Jason Lamb trying to force a man off the puck right there. Check that, that was Verassi. And that might be a penalty. It's the nature of being a more physical team, one that you have to be able to take the hits, but you also have to be able to have a good penalty kill. And two big hits in particular, first Harrison Slovak in the first period and now Anthony Verassi, have led to Iowa State's two penalties. And again, really coming into the last week for the Cyclones, they were sub 10% on the power play. Two power play goals last week against Ohio. And the power play has been the lone source of scoring in this game as well for Iowa State. So maybe they're turning a corner on the man advantage now. That makes these next 2 minutes must win for Illinois as Atticus Helfer eventually clears. Top line on, led by Nelson, the goal scorer in defense. Iowa State looks to get set. He feeds that one to Bestlund near side. Bestlund circles back, has Smith, thought about it. They're looking to go in closer. Odd angle for Bestlund. He has to reorient himself. He's looking to send it across the ice. Those two have played catch for a little while until Smith feeds it to the far side. Iowa State moving in. Bestlund thought about a one-timer. Pass was off. Smith and Bestlund playing catch again before they trade places. Bestlund now at the center point, moving in, fires one, full body block there from Bogdanov. Dives to keep it alive, but Bestlund beats him to it. Smith right there, trying to go in now, trying to find the man in the middle. Great placement there from Helfer to deny that. Smith ends up with it. And Nelson sends it to nobody. Line change for Illinois. That was a beautiful series right there. Even as Iowa State was drifting in closer towards the high slot, Illinois won the day with the full body blocking. Let's see if they can do it for 35 more seconds here on this penalty kill. 50-50 puck battle now. Joe Dorian fighting alongside it. Pulled out to the point and swung out to the far side. Thought about going in. course, to his left. Now back to Smith. Another block there from Matveev. Those two chasing down for it. Matveev has McDonald to his right. Can't get it to him, though, as a deflection off the stick there from Smith. 15 seconds left on the minor penalty. Some great kills here for Illinois. The shot blocking, winning the day over the speed and placement of Iowa State. Able to go around a few men, though, and fire one. That one's still alive. Still caroms close as Mazurek is to his right. Iowa State controls. Sidewinder there goes wide. Out of the box now comes Verassi, and having to chase that one down, Ben Fannenstein. Line changes for both teams. That was a beautiful series of plays right there by Mitch Krebsbach, going through three men to have a chance to finalize the power play. But Mazurek says no, gets some help right in front of the crease defensively again. The defense giving him more run support. That's been a huge help for Illinois over the last month and change. They're trying to gain possession of it. For now, they are dumping it into the Iowa State zone. It's Andrew McLean trying to hold on the forecheck. Now Mulcairn near side. Some short passes, giving the puck to Devonport. Devonport fires, turned aside by Mazurek. Trying to keep it in, off the bench there is Franey. Around to the trapezoid now, Dorian has to get it out quickly. That nearly became dangerous before David Ettingen controls. Now he loses it. Falling down, trying to hold on to that. A few sticks cancel each other out. Ettingen trying to go around one man. Ultimately, it's cleared. Illinois muddying up the game here as they had it in their own D zone. Now after a few more cancel outs, Ettingen able to have it there before it gets poke checked away from him. Ettingen near side, feeds it back to the point. Dorian going in, a few deflections there. Great placement to deny that from Franey. Still fighting for it, that one goes around to the far side. Slovak now, delayed penalty coming up here. Another man goes down, 6-on-5 here for Illinois. They'll have a power play. That one save made off the pad. A rush to get a skate on it from Mulcairn, and he finally does as he sent Joe Dorian into the boards. Alexander Matveev appeared to be a little bit shaken up right there. And we will see what the call is. The call is a hook. And the perpetrator, Andrew Franey, the defenseman. So the third line defenseman will spend the next 2 minutes behind glass, and a beautiful opportunity for Illinois now to tie this game up. Top line back on the ice, led by Bogdanov. Faceoff heads out towards the slot. Matveev, quick lane and a quick save there from Anderson. Fans of both teams applauding, one for quick reaction and one for quick decision making on the shot. So that one will now head to Anderson's right. Power play has been kind to Illinois over the last 3-4 weeks. In particular, can they get set and can they send a few men right in front of the net to cause havoc, to cause those scrums right in the crease that have dominated their power play scoring as of late. Matveev fires another one, still alive in the trapezoid. Verassi sends it to Slovak, far side. Helfer looking to swing it back, now to Slovak. Slovak fires, save made. Karam's back out to a maroon sweater, holding onto that one now, Slovak. He's sent into the boards by the hands of Mitch Krebsbach, still fighting for it. And now Slovak at the half wall will look to reset. 45 seconds having ticked off this power play for Illinois. Matveev trying to chase that one down. The momentum and the miscommunication got the best of the Illini there. Matveev trying to go around a few men. Burst of speed, moving to his left, flying for a lane, shot goes wide. Slovak will look to reset now, sends it to his right, but right to Kirby Larson. Larson gets hit. Can Illinois control? 45 seconds left. Iowa State starting to muddy up the power play and keep things to the boards. Another deflection there, and Illinois will have to reset. Slovak trying to make quick work in the neutral zone, feeds that one in for what is almost a chip and chase. And a clear as a result. That might want to be one he'll have back. dangerous territory here for Illinois. Nearly a few misplays there from Zhizhbekov. Dorian controls near side now. 15 seconds left on the power play. Dorian forced all the way around, thought about a centering pass, but he'll instead try to send it around to the point. Pesky defense right there by Fannenstein to deny Dorian and force it back to the other side. Out of the box now comes Franey. Illinois looking for one. Can't get it. Poked around to the corner and controlled by Iowa State. Ettingen right there on the forecheck before that one goes through a few men. Chase down for it now. Mazurek helps him out. Pearson gets it. Bestlin right there as well. And Pearson pulls it out. Trying to go in front, touch pass, nothing doing there for Bestlin. Resetting now, getting the zone, the captain Pearson feeds it to his right. Two white sweaters right there, however, and Illinois has the possession for the time being. That one goes off the stick of Bogdanoff. He'll look to make do. And now gaining the zone on the other side once again is Pearson. Before he feeds it to nobody, Iowa State has to reset again, and that gives Illinois the possession. Halfway down here in the third period before play is stopped. Matvey pesky with the stick there, and he gains that faceoff. Chips it in. Barassi trying to chase after it. He gets sent into the boards, and Iowa State controls on the far side. Trying to go around a few men, still holding onto that one. Kept alive, however. Shot there, gets deflected, and sent around the crease. Iowa State's throwing it at the wall and sees what sticks here. Backhand chance, save made. They're throwing everything at the wall and seeing what sticks. So the top line takes a breather for Illinois and is replaced by, you guessed it, the second line. Top heavy for John Opilka's squad in this game. And we'll see if that carries over into tomorrow, both personnel-wise and maybe a little bit of lethargy there as well. Slovic in the middle of that, but a 2-on-1 forces that one to the near side corner. Now back around the trapezoid, he gets it right there. That's Sam Eaton who tried to clear it. A lot of sticks canceling each other out now, and a lot of crowding of the puck, but Iowa State with a lane here as the shot goes wide. Near side point, swung around, back to the far side. Cyclones looking to go right back to work. Again, they're throwing everything at the wall and seeing what sticks. That one goes wide, still behind the net. Illinois has to get it out of there. Dorian with some physical play to deny that, and then a good poke there from Bogdanoff. Now Zhizhbekov goes around to few men and fires. Save made, still alive, swallowed up. And that's Eaton and Devonport in the middle of it there. Zhizhbekov had one man to either side of him before he just took it to his defender and went around him and had an open lane. One of the few point-blank saves Brett Anderson has made tonight. He's had to make tonight, that is. Again, if you're an Illinois fan with 8 minutes, 50 seconds left in a one-goal game, see if you can apply some set offensive pressure. Back in the trapezoid. Iowa State clears. The speed for the Cyclones starting to show a little bit more here, as is the physicality for Illinois. Bogdanoff runs after that one, opposing him, Nelson. A few more men cancel each other out as a sidewinder there is not on. at the point, near side. Illinois feeds it in, looking for a redirect. Can't get one there. And a man able to clear it, that's Riley Kress. Iowa State and head coach Guan Wang still wanna know why that icing was called. They are not happy about that. But it gives Illinois a face-off in the offensive zone to the right of Anderson. Matt Veeb wins it, quickly pulled out to Dorian on the near side. Dorian again plays the redirect game. Back to Matt Veeb in the trapezoid. They end up swinging it to the far side. Zhizhebetkov in. They're trying to send it in front, and they're hoping for a scrum right there. It's worked for them plenty of times this season, but it will not work there. Now Iowa State back the other way with numbers. Shot goes wide up the stick of Nelson. Chase down for it. McDonald looking to clear. He does. Nelson has to send it back in on the other side. Kavarik might get it there first, but Zhizhebetkov hammers him into the boards. Great hit there by the young defenseman. A brand new line tonight, a brand new pairing of Zhizhebetkov and Dorian, and they've done pretty well for themselves at different points in this game. Zhizhebetkov now running after that one, opposing him, Sam Dorfman. Those two still going after it as that one ends up in the trapezoid. Looking for a centering pass there is Joe Pacana. Still has it, now on to the far side. Back to the point. They look to feed it in, deflection. And Illinois right there, Dorian and Matt Veeb in front to stop that rebound chance. Stick deflection, but it will still give Sam Dorfman the puck. Delays before he sends that one over the net. Millens gets hit. Espacana tries to make something happen. He will have it back at the point, send it to Millens in that corner. They're looking for a feed right in front. Now they play the periphery. Moving in Kress, denied right there by McDonald, forced to his right. Inside of 7 minutes now as Iowa State starts to gain more control in their own O zone. Into the near side corner at the half wall and back to the point. Kress still has it. Swings it far side for Fannenstein. Kress and now near side to Millens. Iowa State controlling as they fire one. And Mazurek with a veteran play right there. A lot of shifting, a lot of rotation right in front of the net from Iowa State. And in response to that, Illinois. And you started to see Ben Mazurek creep in front past the blue paint just so he could get in front of everyone. It's a high risk, high reward play there, but when you're able to execute it without obstruction from anyone who's trying to cause havoc in front of the net, oftentimes it proves the right move, and it did right there. Illinois trying to clear, Alpi to Slovic. Slovic sent that one across, Bogdanov trying to hold onto it, Anderson will deny that with the stick. Far side battle. 3-on-2 puck battle, that is. Now 3-on-3. Slovic has Ettingen if he wants to feed it to him. Now feeds it in. That one caroms back around. Alpi deflected. And now Illinois will reset inside of 6 minutes to go in a one-goal game. Iowa State starting to show off their speed a little bit more here. That time, Helfer showing off his evasiveness. He has it now, tries to feed it in, Bogdanov. And a save made. And another thing that Iowa State is doing well is Illinois tries to feed it right in front of the net. They're giving the men right in front absolutely no room to work, whether it's Matt Veeb, Bogdanov, Dorian. Illinois in transition has tried to get a bunch of feeds in front, and they're just locking them down, not really giving them any room to move their skates, to move their sticks as well, and pucks are just going right through or deflecting in favor of Iowa State. So a great adjustment really from the get-go that has limited Illinois' ability, save for a few minutes in that second period, to get anything active right in front of the net. The Cyclones control now in the trapezoid. Stu Pearson looks for a feed, has it, still alive in front, and swallowed up again by Mazurek. 32 saves on 33 shots. for his counterpart Anderson. Check that. 32 on 32 and 37 on 38 for Missouri. Faceoff slinged over to the point. And again, Missouri showing off that keen ability to keep his eye on it in heavy traffic. 5 minutes, 11 seconds left, and the advantage has gone to Iowa State in this third period, just for really denying Illinois the ability to get anything set in the five-on-five, any version of the set offense. It's been speed, and it's been locking Illinois down in the slot when they do try to get options in transition. So how does Illinois respond to that? It's been on the season transition hockey and odd man rushes, but they need to get to that point. Right now, Iowa State's controlling things in their own O zone, and Illinois is a little bit out of sorts here, shading heavily to one side. Getting around McDonald right there before feeding it to a man was Pearson. Now Besslin sends it to his left. Shot there is wide. Now Besslin back with it. Matt Vive on his six. Another puck battle. That one Karam towards the half wall. Right there is Mulkarin. Feeds it out there to Nelson. Far side. Larson. Wide again. Trying to keep that one in the O zone. Before he's hammered in is Mulkarin. Still alive there, but cleared. And that will force a tag up and a line change from Iowa State. Atticus Helfer in his own doghouse to his left. Matt Vive tried to send it. McDonald looked for a Karam. Couldn't get one. Iowa State with good positioning here in the neutral zone to deny Illinois over the last 10 seconds. Chase down for it now between Eaton and Helfer. Dorian gets hit into the boards as he tries to clear that. And again, Illinois starting to clear it, but nothing much they can do in the neutral zone. Credit to Iowa State where credit is due. Save made there by Missouri, and credit to him for keeping his team in the game. On the other side, Ettingen, too many deflections there, forces an Illinois reset. 3.5 left on the clock. Illinois needs to start getting some set pressure in the offensive zone. Iowa State muddying things up whenever they can in neutral ice. And probably the one resemblance to the Friday, the more rusty games Illinois has had this season, is their inability to handle some passes. Ettingen fires one wide. That one's still in the trapezoid. Slovak looking for a feed, centering one. A lot of traffic in front there. Zhuzhebetkov tried to send it in. Still being fought for right there behind the net. Still alive. That one caroms out to the point. Zhuzhebetkov sends it to Alpi. Can Illinois get some set pressure in here? Zhuzhebetkov fires too high and to the right. Looking to clear it. There is Eaton. Illinois resets. Slovak looking to make quick work. Can they get some set pressure again? Slovak forced to the outside, feeds it back to Alpi. Alpi has a lane, save made. And a penalty called as a hit on Harrison Slovak. That might be as much of a gift as you can get with 2.5 minutes left in this game. Illinois is going on the power play. The hit on Harrison Slovak by Riley Kress on the near side corner in the Iowa State zone. That is too much life to give a team as good as Illinois. John Opilka will call his timeout. So again, in this third period, Iowa State has muddied up the waters. They've denied Illinois really the chance to get any touch passes, any activity right in front of the net where the Illini have made their home over the last 6-7 games, that being the crease and the low slot in particular. They've just haven't really given opposing players a lot of room to work and a lot of ability to sort of move their skates and their sticks and to get into proper positioning. So that may very well be for a team that has thrived on those scrums right in front of the net and on those rebound doorstep chances. That might be task number one for John Opilka. Task number two is to decide at what time you're going to pull your netminder. 2 minutes, 34 seconds left on the clock. 2 minutes of a power play here, the penalty on Riley Kress. So this could very well be a 6-on-4 for Illinois. Does he pull Missouri a minute in to create that, or does he stick with the man advantage? It's a combination of how much trust you have in your team, and really, too, as Mazurek does make it to his net, it is going to be 5-on-4 for the time being. It may very well be an in-game adjustment, literally within the power play. It may very well be how the first minute goes for Illinois. If they can keep it in their own O zone, I might consider pulling my netminder if I'm John Opelka. Decisions to be made here, and more importantly, the execution for Illinois. Helfer fires, deflected, but caromed right back to a white sweater. That's Slovic and Helfer playing catch. Iowa State keeping Illinois to the periphery. Matt Veeve now. Verassi taking his time on the near side, near that half wall, before he plays the redirect game and trades places with Matt Veeve. Now Helfer at the near side point. Over to Slovic on the other side, fires one, still alive in front. Caroms into the high slot. Matt Veeve a shot, save made, and play stopped. 2 minutes, 1 second left in regulation. Again, it's that top line for Illinois on the ice in the form of a 4-1 overload with Alec Bogdanoff taking the place of Matthew McDonald. Face-off goes Iowa State's way, and that is a huge clear for the Cyclones. Can they muddy it up now in the neutral zone and keep Illinois away from getting set? Illinois does get it quickly into the O zone, and it looks like that answer is going to be a no. Matt Veeve turning around, has to get it away. He's harassed. Now that becomes a 50-50 puck battle. You're right in your wheelhouse now if you're Iowa State. Helfer has to feed it away. Illinois bunched to one side. Can they spread the ice here? That one gets taken away. Now near side, Pearson trying for a backhand. Helfer says no. Illinois fans weren't happy that a penalty wasn't called there on Pearson for the hand shoving with Helfer. Matt Veeve trying to keep it in on the other side. He does, but he goes down. 1:07 left as the Cyclones able to clear it. 30 seconds left on the power play. We have our eyes on Ben Mazurek. 60 seconds left. Illinois looks to get set. Mazurek still there, still a 5-on-4. And another clear. Really, since the win of that faceoff for Iowa State, the turning point in this power play. They've kept Illinois to the outside, forced a lot of one-on-twos and one-on-threes. Another one right there that allows them to clear the puck. 35 seconds left in this game. Back to 5-on-5, and Ben Mazurek is still in net. Last chance here for Illinois. 25 seconds left. Mazurek rushes to the bench. 6-on-5 for Illinois, but they need to get set in the offensive zone. That is a 3-on-3 battle in the trapezoid. Can Illinois get set with an empty net? Iowa State controls. They clear it. And now Alex Leskai has to chase it down. 7 seconds left. Fed in right there. And a late icing call at 2.9 on the clock. And that might very well do it, because that will force an offensive zone faceoff for Iowa State. That faceoff win about halfway through that Illinois power play shut the door in this game. Iowa State was able to muddy things up, keep Illinois to the outside, and really force a lot of one-on-twos in a situation in which overall they were undermanned. Faceoff caroms out towards the Illinois trapezoid, and that is that. Iowa State, in a must-win game, pulls it out by a 1-0 score. The lone goal coming from Ryan Nelson. And for the time being, the Cyclones' playoff hopes are kept alive. A lot of great plays by backup netminder Brett Anderson. The shutout on 35 saves, again for a man who had been a little bit erratic. And again, 21 goals in 4 games entering today, and he shuts the door. And large credit as well to his defense for denying what has become one of Illinois' greatest strengths over the last 3-4 weeks. The scrums, the skirmishes, the second chances in front. Things for Illinois to work on. Well, they had the upper hand on Iowa State for a large part of that second period. That was a combination of speed and when they did have somebody in front before, head coach Guan Wang for the Cyclones was able to make that adjustment. So it'll continue to be a game of adjustments. And another positive takeaway for Illinois is they started to fulfill more of those litmus tests in a Friday game. They were more physical. They did force Iowa State to the outside for a few moments. So certainly some improvements for both sides, but the speed and the poke-checking ability of Iowa State proved to be the difference in this rivalry renewed. Again, the first game between these two in this building in 2.5 years. And again, we will have another one between these two tomorrow at the exact same time. That marks 6 in a row for Iowa State in this rivalry series. And Illinois will look to split the series in what has been generally a much better day for them playing-wise in terms of how clean the games are historically this season, that being Saturday. We will see if that is indeed fulfilled from the Illinois side. Again, Iowa State holding on with an early first period goal, and from there it was a lot of defense to help out backup netminder Brett Anderson. For all of us in the broadcasting crew, this is George Corey saying so long until tomorrow. Iowa State holds on 1-0, and these two teams will match up again about 21 hours from now.